So Nelson Mandela died.
Yes.
95 years old. What a life this guy had. Oh my God.
27 years in the clink, was it?
Yeah.
Do they take bring tours to where he stayed now?
I think so.
Because I saw the cell on TV last night, and I'm like, oh yeah, they probably didn't put anyone else in there after that.
Yeah, I think
it'd be a real big deal to kind of leave it how it was.
I saw some clips of that. Bill Clinton and him in the cell looking out the window, and Clinton has his arm around Mandela,
right?
And like Mandela was trying to like move to one side, not to get away from him on purpose,
right?
But then Clinton like moved over to make sure the camera still saw him with his arm on his back.
Oh, really?
It was so self-serving.
Yeah, Clinton knows how to work.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's a master at that shit.
But all they've been showing is the little white-haired Nelson Mandela. And I got to be honest with you.
That's how the world knows him.
I got to be honest with you. I don't know what this guy's saying. It's like, let's listen to some inspirational words. I don't understand what he's saying.
It's a heavy accent.
It is a heavy accent.
Heavy South African accent.
He was in from 63 to 90, I think. He did.
Yeah.
That's a long fucking time, man.
It certainly is.
That is a lot of jail time.
63 to 90.
Yeah.
So he went in when Kennedy was shot.
Right.
Comes out when Clinton was 90? No.
I think
Clinton. 92.
No, 90. Yeah, 92.
Right. So
George H.W.
Yeah, Bush's father there. That's fucking a long time, man.
Well, he was in there
He was in there for Nixon
treason.
And Reagan and Carter and Ford and LBJ. Wow.
And there
a lot of presidents.
For treason and communism. You know, he was trying to overthrow the government. And they didn't take kindly to that, so they threw him in the clink.
But you know they wish they would have killed him. Like, after they saw what happened when he got out and the fact that he became president, they probably wish we should have just killed this guy and taken the heat back in.
Yeah, they kind of blew it.
Yeah.
As far as they're concerned, right. Yeah, you got to add that, of course. And then, and then his wife says, all right, I'm out.
She had some weird shit happen. Winnie Mandela had a lot of.
She was a fucking nasty woman.
Yeah, they said she's dead now, right?
She would necklace those fucking the opponents.
Yeah,
that's when you take a tire, you fill up the tire with gasoline, put it around someone's neck, and light it on fire.
Yeah, and the tire melts into you. It's a brutal death,
horrible way to die. And that's what.
They would roll you. I heard that they would roll you sometimes down a hill, like while you're just so you can't do anything.
Yeah, yeah.
He became like super militant while he was in jail.
Oh,
like violent.
That's
like
a hell of a way to get rid of tires, though, man. Why not just stack them up like
the
rest of us?
Right?
I
know,
right? The smell is so nice.
Could recycle them or something.
He had a lot of quotes, that Mandela.
Oh, yeah.
The one about no one is born hating is one of my favorites. I don't know the exact quote, but something like that. No one is born hating. It's kind of brilliant if you think about it.
He did. Spike Lee got him for Malcolm X. It was really a great ending. Spike Lee really knows how to end a film. And he was in Malcolm X, but he wanted him to deliver Malcolm X's line about in this world, by any means necessary. But Mandela wouldn't do the whole speech. He didn't want to say by any means necessary. I guess because that implied that he was willing to be violent, and he wasn't.
Right.
So the way Spike did it was Mandela stood there at the end. It was really amazing that he got him for this. And he delivered the entire speech, you know, whatever. It was very brief. Mm-hmm. And then for the last line, he just fucking dubs in Malcolm X really quick, and it cuts to Malcolm X saying. It was really great. If you've never seen the end of Malcolm X, it was very well done. But I kind of thought it was interesting that Mandela...
Can we see that clip? I haven't seen that clip.
From Malcolm X?
It's the last... I think the last moment in X.
So Malcolm X / Mandela. Mm.
Yeah, so, boy, the tribute's just pouring in. The news, nonstop. And I'm certain every world leader will make the pilgrimage to South Africa for his funeral.
Well, Michael Moore had a wonderful tweet about Nelson Mandela and our president.
How is the United States responsible for the death
of
Nelson Mandela? How are white people responsible?
Someone look that up real fast.
How should we all feel guilty based on...
I should have had some of these tweets printed out.
Michael fucking Fetso Moore.
He had a wonderful tweet about it. Really
did he?
Oh, yes, he did.
He is a fucking asshole. Just a fucking asshole.
I like him. I like my
He's
Moore.
A phony crock of shite.
But he was in studio, and we treated him with nothing but kindness.
Yeah.
He was nice to us, too.
Just go to his Twitter, because I'm sure it's, you know,
Still up.
Yeah.
Like Paris Hilton's tweet? That wasn't really her tweet.
No, of course
though.
Not. But it was very funny whoever did that.
But it's being carried as her tweet, and it was hilariously funny. Somebody said, Nelson Mandela, I loved your I Have a Dream speech. It was so inspiring.
Right.
And then she goes, I was on a plane and somebody tweeted.
Oh, shut up, you.
you dumb cunt. Shut up.
Yeah, just no sense of humor about herself.
Shut up.
Fucking dumb large feet that I want to suck.
With your dumb fucking deer caught in headlight eyes on your porno.
And great songs.
Horrible.
Wait.
Starting here.
Those are all the Mandelas?
Yeah, start.
All right, why don't you read all of them then?
All right, starts with Thank You, Mandela, Freedom.
Yep.
That's good.
Skip the retweets. And then he writes, one was convinced Nelson Mandela would never get out of prison. When he did and became president, I decided right then anything was possible.
Who's that?
Michael Moore saying all this.
Oh, okay. Anything's
possible.
He's quoting, love your enemy, do good to those who persecute you.
Why are you dunking a basketball? Is that did that become possible? No.
Oh, here's the one. This is the one that really got me. This was very inspirational. Go ahead.
From Michael Moore on Twitter.
Yep.
President Obama, please attend Nelson Mandela's funeral on behalf of all of us.
How about shut the fuck up, fatso?
How dramatic.
Yeah. So dramatic.
Everyone go for their moment.
It's on
behalf of all of us. All of us.
Don't speak for me, you tub of lard. Christ.
Can you go to the celebrity tweets? I go right to the celebrities when something huge happens.
You know what that's going to cost?
Because it gets so douchey.
I got to tell you guys. Earl had a very profound.
Oh, what did he write?
Nelson Mandela.
What did he write?
He wrote, "Rest in power, Mr. Mandela."
Damn it, that's fucking powerful.
That's rest in power.
You have surely earned your rest.
Bravo,
you
Earl.
Earned your rest.
Like being dead is comfortable.
Yeah, exactly. You got formaldehyde shoved up your asshole.
Yeah.
Your fucking hands are folded. You can't even scratch your bag. It's awful being dead.
Jesus.
All right, run down some of the better celebrity tweets about Nelson Mandela, because they all try to go for their
big moment.
Dramatic moment. Big, huge, moment. Over-the-top moment.
I'll give you the celebrity.
They want to speak for all of us.
Yes.
You tell me to skip it or if you want to hear it. Yoko Ono.
Of course.
Of course.
Oh, I wish I could have broken up his band.
She writes, thank you, Nelson Mandela, for your highest standard of commitment to peace in our world. We are so lucky to have been on this planet with you.
Oh, okay. A little much, but it's not bad.
Planet.
Which is the next celebrity?
Missy Elliott?
Oh, fuck yeah. She's going to wear the garbage bags. I like this broad.
You mean Missy Misdemeanor?
Yes.
Yeah.
Hashtag RIP Nelson Mandela. We can't thank you enough for all the wisdom you have given to the world. A true leader and loved by so many. Hashtag RIP.
Psst, he's not reading right now.
Yeah. He doesn't have Twitter at this point.
Let's see.
Jermaine Dupri.
No.
Catherine Heigl.
Catherine Heigl.
Yeah, what'd she say? She's right. Important.
She is deeply saddened to hear of the passing of Nelson Mandela, an inspiration to all who value freedom, democracy, and equality.
There you go.
Let's see. We've got Marlon Wayans.
Let's hear the Wayans.
Is this funny? Did he make a funny tweet?
A little joke? Yeah. R.I.P. Nelson Mandela.
Was it like his movies?
R.I.P. Nelson Mandela. It will take a world of people to grab the baton that you ran with to continue your tradition. May we all grab hold.
Oh, that's dramatic. Maybe I'll grab my baton. My dick.
I know you did. I'm reaching for it.
Charlize Theron.
Oh, who is South African, by the way.
She is a white South African. Sexy. So
did you see her on that commercial for that fucking, what was it, perfume or something? And she's on the runway, kind of walking with a snobby model face. God, she looks good.
She's working it.
All right, but she's white. She's abroad from South Africa, so she was feeling a lot of pressure, so I'm sure this is going to be a terrific tweet.
Yeah.
What did she write?
See, I'd fuck an African chick. Her.
My thoughts and love go out to the Mandela family. Rest in peace, Madiba.
Madiba, that's what close friends call him.
Well,
that's his clan name.
A lot of people out there using that to feel like they know a little more than the rest of us.
That's like when you get a tweet that says, okay, Greg.
Yeah. A name that I haven't used since I was 12.
Yeah.
She added that in because that's that Madiba is like, hey, don't forget. Yeah. I'm from there.
Isn't there a new Madiba movie coming out this Christmas?
It's not.
Is there?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't think it's the same.
What?
Madiba.
Yeah.
Is it Tyler Perry?
Yeah.
Tyler
Perry's Madiba,
Madiba Christmas.
Yeah.
Madiba Christmas is coming out?
I swear it is. Yeah.
Samuel L. Jackson.
Motherfucker.
Yeah. Does he have a motherfucker in his tweet? Any MFs?
He wrote, he had to name drop a little bit here.
All right.
Never met a better person in my life than Nelson Mandela.
Met him. Did he post a picture too? Everyone that met, all the celebrities that met them, they just couldn't get their pictures up quickly.
Yeah,
enough.
That's a good one to have.
I would have posted.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Whoopi Goldberg.
Did they keep him? Did they keep Mandela in his friend's garage up there in Toluca Lake for a little while?
I know.
Weekend at Bernie's?
No.
Pulp.
No?
A little pulp perfect action.
Oh, I was thinking they kept...
I'm there.
Really? No?
I'm there.
And can't help himself.
Okay. Justin Timberlake.
No, Whoopi. Why would you pass on Whoopi? She's a big fucking deal, this Whoopi.
Oh, yeah.
Wake up with Whoopi.
Yes.
I want to give the... Okay, you're right about this one. I want to give the world a hug.
Wow, that's tough.
I was told Mandiba just passed.
Mandiba? Oh.
Nelson Mandela, RIP. Time for a well-earned sleep. Condolences to his family.
It's not sleep.
He's not sleeping.
He's not dead. Sleeping, and they're not going to read the tweets. Why did you say Mandiba? She probably said the wrong button.
He's going to be...
That's his name.
He starts being dead for billions Mandiba. And billions of years.
Yes.
It's not a sleep.
It's a long sleep.
Is it Madiba or Mandiba?
It's Madiba.
It's Madiba.
So she wrote Mandiba.
I know, because she thought she knew.
Justin Timberlake. Now, Justin Timberlake is important.
JT has a lot of followers, so he was feeling pressure, too.
Let's not forget how much of that black culture Justin Timberlake is taking on.
He's embracing it.
Rips off.
Well, yeah, rips off.
Yeah, I'd say that's accurate.
How's Shade doing over there? Are they okay today? Should we all give them a hug?
I don't think the show started just
yet. I'm seeing some black people gathering outside the studio. Yeah.
The people who do the show every morning.
Yeah.
Let's do the Timberlake.
Justin Timberlake, one of our greatest...
All caps.
...leaders.
Damn it, that's the way to do that.
Our.
Thank you for being...
All caps. Bravo.
...the true meaning of compassion. May you be at peace now. Hashtag RIP Nelson Mandela.
I gotta say, maybe I'm playing the devil's advocate here, but Sun City was a great place. Nice beach, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fucking entertainment.
Ain't gonna play Sun City. Why are we playing
that
today?
We should play that, because that was the big...
Ain't gonna play Sun City.
That was like the We Are the World for anti-apartheid.
It sure was.
Ain't gonna play Sun City. Bono was in it.
We'll go back to the tweets, but wait, I want Sam to play the video, because I want to see...
Yeah, I want to see what celebrities...
I want to see what celebrities were big at the time that aren't anymore.
Yes! Yes, and Sun City was like the big place to play in South Africa. And then, of course, they put a little embargo on that.
All right, let's look at the artists.
We ain't playing Sun City no more.
What year was that?
Sun City. Oh, 80s. Probably like 84, I'm going to guess.
85.
85. That was close.
African blacks have been relocated.
Oh.
It's a lavish resort where you can relax and enjoy some of the world's
without Negroes, right?
It's part of the reality of apartheid.
It's a pro-apartheid.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
Oh, man. Now they're showing some...
Not good.
And now it's the other way around. Now it's black people killing white people down there. It's amazing. They changed that all up.
This was an alright song.
And nah.
Oh, man. Some people get hit with truncheons. Hey,
right, we got the one DMC. All right. All right, who are those two?
Hold on. That's, wait, go back. Is that Grandmaster Flash?
It was, right?
Yeah. And Afrika Bambaataa, or I'm not sure who the other guy was.
Huh?
I know it was Grandmaster Flash.
Grandmaster Flash?
All right. And the guy on the right here looks pretty,
He looks familiar. Yeah, who's familiar. The guy on the left?
Left is a fat guy.
Yeah, no clue.
Fat black guy.
Ja Rule?
All right, keep going.
This is old school, yo. This is 80s, yo.
Right.
Houdini?
Little Steve.
E. Nice.
He had a big part in this, right?
I think so.
Damn.
Bono!
Bono!
Of course you got the Bono.
I'm guessing some pips right there. Maybe some pips. Who's that guy?
I don't know who that guy is.
He's old school.
Hey, it's Pat Benatar. The boss.
It's Bruce.
And who's that guy on the right? We know that guy on the right. Place on Sit-Tow.
Who's that on the left with the fucking...
I don't know. It's just like a space-age general. Pat Benatar again.
Not a lot of stars.
No, what happened?
Oh, that guy.
George Clinton.
Right. Oh, Howard Stern.
Come on, Howard Stern.
Howie!
it's Hall.
Daryl Hall.
What, the Oates didn't believe?
I don't know. Oates was like, fuck it, I'll play. Who's that? Look at that. A very white person by the pool.
It almost looked like Boy George or something, but it wasn't.
I never heard this.
No, Jimmy.
This was a huge
thing.
This was
massive.
Hey, it's the clerk.
And there's the man himself, Nelson Mandela, as a young fella.
Nelson was still in prison.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Oh, it's Bonnie Raitt.
With that stupid
nice gray hair. Oh, there's Oates.
All right, Oates just didn't want to be with
Lou
Daryl.
Lou Reed in the back. Oh, shut
nice.
Up, Lou. Lou's not singing.
I like Lou more since he died. Starting to dig Lou Reed, finally.
That was Howard, now that's Boy Gary. Yeah. With Bono. Bono needs a big solo part.
Oh.
Didn't Bono have a solo part in this?
It's a long song. How much longer is this song?
8.5 minutes.
Oh my god.
Damn.
It's not even half over.
Still got another 4 to go.
Oh, they're showing like barbed wire going by.
It's Friday.
Sure.
It's a pretty cool video though for the fucking 80s.
Oh yeah.
He's a rock.
Is that Houdini? Or no?
Oh, now they're showing dead people.
God, I just don't know these guys. That guy looks ridiculous.
Oh,
Daryl Hall.
Daryl Hall.
I mean, Daryl Hannah and Jackson Brown.
Bob Dylan was there. Oh, it's star-studded now. Lou Reed again.
You know that Jackson Brown kind of understood.
It's Jay Giles.
Jackson Brown understood some of their tactics.
Yes.
He used a few of them on Miss Hannah.
Who's that guy?
I don't know. Guy from Hills Have Eyes?
Yeah, he looked like
that.
There's Bono.
That was Midnight Oil guy.
Oh, yes.
Lead singer Midnight Oil.
Bono with the fucking evil Bono beard.
And that dumb hairdo.
Yeah.
And fucking bouffant hairdo.
It's 80s Bono.
Oh, we got to sing with Bono. That guy's a nobody.
Hey, it's Ringo playing the drums. Action. And then they probably redid the drum track.
This was back when Ringo was still accepting fan mail.
Yes.
Sure was.
Yeah, where's McCartney?
McCartney didn't care.
Yeah, he didn't believe in this shit.
He's in some city. All play anywhere. Yeah. Oh, the guy from...
Peter Gabriel. And that was Jay Giles. Did we say Jay Giles?
Jay Giles guy.
Some fat dude.
Rerun. I don't know. This is star-studded.
Yep.
They're always doing the Jay Giles dance.
Yeah.
I don't think any of these rappers have any money anymore.
No.
Probably not.
Except for Run DMC.
You know what? They should have played Sun City and banked that money.
No kidding. Invest properly.
Yeah. Oh, the Dr. Reverend Martin Luther King.
How much longer?
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
This is as long as fucking Mandela was in jail.
No, that was years after.
All right. Clarence.
Clarence.
That might be Boy George in the back.
Yeah.
A younger Boy George.
Bruce still dancing with the black people. Bono kissing black people. This is amazing. Oh, a hairband guy. Lou Reed again. I don't know, some Egyptian people. Everybody was wearing hipster hats.
Except they were just cool.
Yes.
Can you go to the list of people that were in this
black
video?
People. Na na na, yeah.
Yeah! Yeah!
Bruce.
It's just a little fucking redundant at this point. We got it.
We got it. We're not supposed to go there. This really put it over the top, though. Because it wasn't long after this that they're like, man, if the celebrities won't play our resorts, we're fucked.
Fucked.
Right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Who wrote this?
It's very catchy.
It's actually Adolf Hitler, so.
It was Stevie Van Zandt?
Wasn't?
Yeah, I thought he had a lot to do with this. He was a big deal.
Hey, Tom.
Wow, that's right.
Uh-oh. Oh, they love that Lion King-sounding music. They've been singing that in front of Nelson Mandela's home there in Soweto. And I call it Lion King music. Because it all sounds like the Lion King.
Well, yeah. I figured that's why he called it that.
That Lion King-y music.
Let's see who is
in this. Matata means no worries the rest of your... What?
I've never seen it.
Okay.
All right, go through this really fast. You could skip a bunch. Well, no, you don't know some of these guys like we do.
Yeah.
Little Steven.
I know who he is.
Oh, yeah.
DJ Herc.
Cool DJ Herc.
He was one of those
rap
guys.
You know Cool DJ Herc?
Yeah, he was big. From the Bronx. He was a really influential guy in rap. He had a lot to do with getting it off the ground.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Stiv Bators.
You ever heard of him?
Yeah, Stiv.
Peter Wolf, Curtis Blow, Pat Benatar.
Oh, Curtis Blow. That was the one with the fucking little
Curtis
mustache.
Curtis Blow, yes.
That you said might be, you're kidding with
Who
Ja Rule.
Duke.
Duke Booty.
Duke!
Oh, that's who that guy was. David Ruffin.
All right.
Oh. Temptations. Eddie Kendricks, Joey Ramone, Jimmy Cliff, Daryl Hall, Lou Reed, Jackson Brown, Bob Dylan, Nona Hendrix, Kashif, Big Youth, Peter Garrett, the Malapoets.
Oh,
some of these were South African artists.
I'm certain.
Of course.
Gil Scott Heron, Afrika Bambaataa, you're right. Ruben Blades, Bono, George Clinton, Peter Gabriel, Linton Kwesi Johnson. Grandmaster Melly Mel.
Melly Mel. Motherfucking Melly Mel.
Melly Mel.
That was the guy that was
dressed
like
up all crazy. Yeah.
Yes.
Bonnie Raitt, Run DMC, Bruce Springsteen, John Oates, Michael Monroe, Darlene Love, the Fat Boys.
Nice.
Ray Barretto.
All right, you don't have to continue, I guess.
Ringo Starr.
Oh, then they had
Townsend.
Pete Townsend just played guitar. Keith Richards, Ron Wood. Jesus.
Clarence Clemons.
Were they in the video, though?
Miles Davis. Herbie Hancock. Wow. Jam Master Jay. Daryl Hannah.
Yeah, she was going out with fucking
Jackson Brown
at the time. So he kind of fucking threw
his
a little
music
bomb.
Music always fucking bored me.
It's boring music.
Thank you.
Lawyers in Love.
Yeah, he's a real douche. Rolling Stone loves him. Oh,
he's a genius.
Now the seats are all empty. Let the roadies take. All right, in real time, you're breaking down the stage.
They're
great.
Empty because they know what you did to Daryl Hannah.
Oh.
They ran for their lives.
Wasn't he belting her around
That's
a little bit?
That's what I'm saying. I made a million fucking...
Did he?
Yeah, there were allegations of him punching.
Oh, you didn't know that?
Yeah. No.
I made about five fucking Jackson Brown beating up Daryl Hannah jokes in there.
I didn't catch him. I had no idea.
I said he learned well from what was going on in South Africa because he went and kind of had some of the same stuff going on.
Right.
It was not nice to Daryl Hannah.
No. Well, that was...
All right, let's go back to the tweets now.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, celebrities tweeting about Nelson Mandela.
All
trying
going
to get
for the moment.
Trying to get their moment. Trying to get their tweet quoted in the papers.
We were up to Beyoncé.
Yeah, she's a big Beyoncé. Deal. What'd she have to say?
Thank you for all you have sacrificed to improve the lives of other human beings. Rest in peace. God bless.
God bless.
We're really looking for the ones that are really over the top. I understand why people would tweet about him, but it's the ones that are trying way too hard for the moment.
Goldie Hawn.
Okay.
What?
A light has gone out on this world.
What?
R.I.P. with the other angels, dear Nelson.
Damn it, that's good. She's a good fucking one. Poet.
Paris Hilton's real tweet was
from
just
the girl that used to paint fucking shit on herself and dance provocatively.
Paris Hilton's real tweet.
Yes, not the fake one that went viral yesterday. Yeah,
fake tweet.
I think
nothing
I know
to do with I Have a Dream.
Was it, Nelson Mandela passed away, but I'm still a self-centered cunt. That should have been our tweet.
Yes,
it's true.
Just landed and heard the sad news about Nelson Mandela. He was a true hero, and the world is a better place because of him. May he rest in peace.
Oh, God, someone wrote that for her.
Yeah, I think
she couldn't come up with that.
You're absolutely right. She actually wrote, I just landed, and then I said we should mention Mandela.
Yeah, yeah, oh.
Yeah, this is what you're talking about. Tori Amos.
All right, so you went for the moment?
Go
ahead.
Oh, no.
R.I.P. Nelson Mandela, a truly great and courageous man who will always to be an inspiration to the world.
Whoops.
Sleep well, Madiba.
Ew.
Madiba.
Sleep well. Stop making death look fucking beautiful.
Yeah.
You're going to rot.
Errol.
Stinks. Death stinks.
Oh, because he was old. They're like, sleep. He needed to sleep.
He was 95. I mean, that's a fucking great age.
I retweeted Bethany Frankel.
Yes, Bethany.
And I, read her tweet, and then I'll tell you what I.
A truly inspirational person who will never be forgotten. # RIP Nelson Mandela.
So I picked her. I tweeted her, and then I added, sorry for your loss.
Oh, yes. Because she's. She's so in with the Mandela family.
Right.
Bethany. You ever watch that abomination of a show?
I do watch, because we do watch a lot of daytime TV, because that's when we're kind of up after the radio show. Mm-hmm. It's horrendous.
It's really, really bad.
But, I mean, it's not made for us.
No.
You got to keep that in mind.
That's true.
It's made for, you know, broads, and they are, you know, they're...
It's made
for
gals.
They have different, they have different brains than us. They have... different chemistry. Who else in there?
Busta Rhymes, Busta Bus, was the only one who wrote his all in caps.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Okay.
R.I.P. to one of our last truly great kings and god of our universe.
What? He's a king and a god.
Kings and god.
Wow.
All right.
The late, great Nelson Mandela. I will forever love you, great man and great mind. All caps. And also, it's like four, the number four ever. Right. U is the letter U.
Nice.
I see Randy Jackson. Which Randy Jackson is that?
The dog.
Oh,
the dog pound.
Oh.
Oh. So he couldn't get Randy Jackson on Twitter, so he had to add Yo.
Yo.
Yo, Randy Jackson. Yo _ Randy Jackson.
I like Ricky Martin's.
Oh,
okay.
Uh-oh.
It's always Ricky is always ready to celebrate.
Yeah.
Yes.
Ricky's tweet was, there is a party in heaven. Angels are celebrating. The one and only Nelson Mandela has arrived.
Yeah, you think they do that?
Someone's got to tell Ricky he's not going to heaven.
You think they plan it?
Why do you say that?
Well, you know.
Certain choices?
According to the Bible.
Do you think God took
Ricky's
the day off?
Ricky's not going to heaven.
Do you think God took the day off to prepare for Nelson's party up in heaven?
Yeah, I think he did, and I think he also did that while he's worried about subatomic particles and quasars and black holes. He figured, let me take the day off.
Yeah, I'm going to take the day off.
So if he's God, he doesn't have to worry about any of that shit.
Exactly. That's true. And there's no party in heaven.
No?
No.
Well, what kind of music they play, Ricky? Maybe yours. Yeah. Shut up.
To bring in Nelson Mandela's body to the Apollo, I saw it on the marquee. What?
I actually believed you for a second.
Well, look at the marquee. You tell me what that means.
Well, the marquee just says... Nelson Mandela.
Right. So that means he's going to be appearing at the Apollo Theater.
Yeah. How are they going to get him to rub the log?
Just rub his dead
hand. Yeah, yeah. It's dead. And then the Sandman comes out, puts a hook on the handle of the coffin, just drags him off stage.
Any other the top celebrity tweets?
I don't know. Kevin Hart, Burton.
What did Kevin write?
LeVar Burton.
Kevin wrote, the definition of strength is Nelson Mandela.
It was like Hulk Hogan.
R.I.P. greatness icon.
Nice.
All right, well, that sucked. To hear the Opie and Anthony Show 5 days a week, live on satellite radio, online on your phone or tablet, or even on demand, go to SiriusXM.com. Also, interact with the Opie and Anthony Show on Twitter, @Opie Radio, @Anthony Cumia, and @Jim Norton.